सर।
ओके, सो गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। इन टुडेज लेक्चर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द यूनिट नंबर टू, डेटाबेस मॉडल्स, आई एम गोइंग टू कवर फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स। फर्स्ट वन इज रिलेशनशिप, व्हाट इज मीन बाय रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द एंटिटीज। देन रिलेशनशिप सेट्स। Then I am going to complete degree of relationship, cardinality constraints that we are going to see. It's very interesting and you will feel quite interesting point. Then next is participation constraints. Once you come across this participation constraint, you can understand what is mean by constraints. So first, we are starting with relationship. As the name suggests, relationship. What is mean by relationship? We are forming an association between two entities. It is called as a relationship. In the real world, we use the term relationship to do association between two things. That is nothing but the relationship. The basic concept is the finding or associating a particular relationship between two entities. It is called as relationship. In technical world, it is called as association among two entities. So relationship is used to describe the relation between entities. So diamond is used to represent the relationship. We will see one example. The association among entities is called relationship. Keep in mind, you need to have association among the entities. That is nothing but the relationship. In technical, what is mean by relationship? The association among entities is called as relationship. We will see this with example. For example, employee works at a department. So this works at is the relationship between the employee and department. Take another example. The student, this is the entity, and course is an entity. So relationship enters to the association between student and course. How? A student enrolls in a course. Student enrolls in a course. So this enrolls form the relationship between student entity and course entity. So this is called enrolls is called as relationship between student and course. So relationship is an association among several entities. Take another example. We can define the relationship advisor. We can define relationship advisor. That associate instructor, for example, name of the instructor, Dr. Kishore, with a student, Shankar. So student and instructor, in between student entity and instructor entity, relationship is what? Advisor. Instructor Dr. Kishore is advisor to student Shankar. So this relationship specifies that Dr. Kishore is an advisor to student Shankar. So enroll is a relationship that exists between the student and course, just we have seen. And this is the way to represent the relationship between the two entities. This is our entity student. You have to represent entity in a rectangle. This is our student, sorry, course is the another entity. And this is the relationship and which is represented by diamond. So to represent relationship In ER diagram, you have to use the diamond. This diamond indicates it is a relationship between student and course. So what is the relationship over here? Here, student enrolls to the course. So this enrolls is a relationship between student and course. So again, I am repeating, this is our first entity student, this is our second entity course. The relationship between the course and student is enrolls, and it forms the association among two entities, that is student and course. And how we have formed the relationship? Student enrolls for the course. So this is called as relationship. Next is, what is relationship sets? A set of relationship of similar type is called a relationship set. So again, come to the basic notation. What is mean by set? Set is nothing but number of elements present. That is called a set. Again, we have seen one example of relationship, that is enrolls. So one student enrolls for one course. So this is one thing. Whereas number of sets are there, then it becomes relationship set. It is called as relationship set. A set of relationship, just keep in mind, set of relationship of similar type is called as a relationship set. So this is the technical terms. A relationship set is mathematical relation on n is greater than or equal to 2. It is possibly non-distinct sets. Suppose if E1, E2, E3 and EN are entity sets. Okay, the entity sets given the name as E1, E2, E3 and so on to EN. The relationship set R is the subset of this. So this is the notation. This is our entity set E1 to EN, and this particular E1 belongs to this entity set E1, this E2 element belongs to this entity set E2, and so on. And this EN belongs to EN. So this is this relationship R is a subset of this. E1, E2, EN, all belongs to the E1. This E1 is belongs to this E1, this E2 is belongs to this E2, and so on. So this all are E1, E2, EN are the relationship. So here it is the example. This each belongs to the advisor. I will explain this with the help of diagram so that you will get the, you will understood what is mean by a relationship set. So these are the two entity set, instructor and student. Okay, this is our entity set for instructor, and this is our entity set for student. So now we are going to form the relationship between the instructor and student, that is advisor. So here it is called as a relationship set. So this is the instructor and this is the advisor relationship. Okay, so this instructor is advisor for this student. This instructor is advisor for these two students, Shankar and Jain. So this Srinivasan instructor is advisor to the Brown. This Kim instructor is advisor to the AO, and so on. And this is all are nothing but the set. This is our set. And we are forming the relationship between the instructor and student, that is advisor. And these are the relationship. This is our first relation second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. It is one of the, this is again a set. This relationship again is a set. That's why it is called as relationship set. I think you can understood this by looking at this diagram. There are entity set over here. They are mapped to student with this relationship advisor, and it is again set. That's why it is called as relationship set. So the same things with some properties. The association between entity set is referred to as participation. Okay, the association between entity set, it is referred to as participation. That is, entity set E1, E2, EN participate in relation R. That is called as participation. Or a relational instance, that is ER schema, represent an association between the named entities in the real world enterprise that is being modeled. Take one example over here. The individual instructor entity cat, who has instructor ID 45565 and student entity Shankar, who has student ID 12345 and participates in the relationship instance of advisor. So this CATS is advisor for the student Shankar, whose ID is 12345. So the relationship instance represents that the university, that the instructor cat is advisor to the student Shankar. Next one thing is, the function that the entity plays in a relationship is called that entity's role. The function that the entity plays is a relationship. In a relationship is called that entity's role.